open our hearts so that we can see you, our spiritual minds, our spiritual hearts. Father God, give us that desire to worship you, to obey you, to seek hard after you. Your word says, oh God, that when we seek you, you will allow us to find you. When we stand at the door and knock, you will allow the door to be opened. Father God, you said, Lord God, that when we ask of you in Jesus' name, Lord God, that you would bless us according to your word and your purpose for our lives. And so for that, oh God, we are grateful. We are grateful that we have eyes to see beyond what we can see in the natural. Father God, this morning we praise you that we have a heart to receive and believe all that you have for us. And Lord God, we decree and declare that our best days are in front of us, that we are moving forward into our future, and nothing can hinder us and nothing can stop us. And so Father God, for that, Lord, we have a heart and a mind of gratitude. Father, we praise you this morning. We glorify you this morning. We lift up your name on high. There is no greater name than the name Jesus. And so, Father God, we are so thankful that it is in Jesus' name that we are coming through. It is in Jesus' name that we are coming out. It is in Jesus' name that everything is turning around in my favor. Come on, make it personal, Father. We decree it and we declare that it is so. Father, you said in your word to remind you of your word, and your word says whatever we bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever we loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. We loose the blessings and the promises of Abraham, Lord God. You decreed and declared that Abraham, that you would bless him when he goes in, you would bless him when he comes out. Everywhere the soles of his feet, Lord God, would step, that you would bless him with that land and that territory, that his seed from generation to generation to generation would be blessed. Now I decree and declare, Father God, as your servant, that your people, that we are blessed. We are blessed coming in. We are blessed going out. We are blessed wherever the soles of our feet step. Lord God, we decree and declare it according to your promise, Lord God, that we are blessed. Our children are blessed. That we and our families are covered with the blood. Even as the children of Israel, Lord God, at Passover, when the death spirit came, it had to pass over their homes, Lord God, because of the blood of the Lamb. Now I release the blood of Jesus, the blood of the Lamb, be on our families, be on our homes, be on our vehicles, be in our minds, be upon our souls. Father, I thank you that we are cleansed from the crown of our head to the soles of our feet. And I decree and declare that today is your day. Today is the day the Lord has made, and we are rejoicing in it, and we are being glad in it, and we are moving into our future, and our future in Christ Jesus is brighter than our past. Now, Lord God, we praise you for what you did in the past, and we praise you for what you're doing right now in this new day. But Lord God, we also praise you for our future, for we know, Lord God, the plans, the desires, the hope and the purpose that you have for us, and it is to prosper us. It is to bless us. And Lord God, we come in agreement with your word that we, your children, that we are blessed, that we are the head and not the tail. Come on, come in agreement with this prayer. Begin to give me some hearts. Begin to decree and declare, even as I'm praying right now, that we are blessed. Begin to type in the comment box. Begin to give fire emojis. Begin to share. Begin to like. Come on, engage in this moment as we pray, as we make the declaration that we are blessed. We are the head and we're not the tail. For your word, God, says that you're Alpha and Omega. You are the beginning and the end. And so, God, we are in you. Come on, somebody begin to put that in the comment box. God, you are the Alpha and Omega. Come on, somebody put that in the comment box. God, you are the Alpha and Omega. You are our beginning. You are in between and our end. We can do nothing without you but fail, God. And that's why we praise you. Come on, get connected to this prayer. Be in this moment. Don't allow this moment to get by you. Don't be a watcher. Don't be a spectator. Be a child of God that activates the word of truth, because you know the word of God is coming to pass for you. Come on, do I have somebody that knows that as we pray, the word of God is coming to pass We annihilate everything that gets in our way. We annihilate every enemy, Lord God, that tries to hinder us, that tries to stop us. And we decree and declare that today is the day that you made. And Father, we are already victorious in Christ Jesus. And we decree and declare, Satan, the Lord has already rebuked you, and now we come in agreement with the word of God. Holy Spirit, strengthen our minds. Holy Spirit, strengthen our souls. Holy Spirit, strengthen our hearts and cause us to move forward, Lord God, with no hindrances and no blockages. We decree and declare that we are seated in heavenly places with Christ Jesus, and that our enemies, Lord God, is our footstool, that we don't worry, we don't concern ourselves, that every diabolical attack, every demon and every devil and every person that comes in agreement with any demon that tries to come up against us, we thank you that those demons and those enemies and those forces, that they are already annihilated, Lord God. We decree it and we declare it, that our enemies are annihilated. Come on, begin to put that in the comment box. Our enemies are annihilated. Come on, begin to type it in the comment box. We are praying right now. We are decreeing and declaring the word of truth right now. Don't be a spectator. Come on, be in the moment. Give me some likes. Give me some thumbs up. Give me some praying hands. Make these declarations. This is prophetic and apostolic prayer. We are destroying the works of the enemy. All clutter, all negative sound, all negative energy that have been sent our way, we annihilate it right now with the light of God, with the life of Christ. No weapon that is formed against us and our family should be able to prosper. We are coming through, we are coming out, and we're coming out on top. We decree and declare, according to Ephesians chapter 2, that we are seated in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, that we have authority, that we have power. The Bible says that God gave Jesus all authority and all power, and now we take our position as Christ-like. We take our position in the earth, and we walk in authority. We walk in boldness. We walk in power. We proclaim that today is the day that the Lord has made, and he has made us to be victorious in it. Every imp, every wimp, every witch, every warlock, every soothsayer, every clique, every gang, every enemy that clicks up together, even as they tried to come against the children of Israel in 2 Chronicles chapter 20, the Bible says that Ammon and the Moabites and all these different armies gathered together. But God said that in his word, as his people began to pray, as his people began to praise, there was a shift in the spirit. And I decree and declare this morning, as we are praying for ourselves, praying for our families, as we are decreeing and declaring the word of truth that is coming to pass in our lives, that our lives are going to be fruitful, that we're going to see the purpose of God come to pass, that we're going to see the vision and the plan of God come to pass. We're going to see the vision and plans that we have written down for our families come to pass. We're going to see the blessings of the Lord that make us rich and add no sorrow. I release the richness of heaven to come your way even now. I release the richness of heaven to come your way even now. And I decree and declare that you're overflowing with finances. I decree and declare that you're overflowing with riches in Christ Jesus. I decree and declare that you're prosperous in every area of your life. You're prosperous in your relationship with God. You're prosperous in your relationship with your mate. You're prosperous in your relationship with your mother, your father. You're prosperous in your relationship with your children and with your siblings. When the enemy came in to divide and conquer, the word of God says when the thief be found, he's got to restore. Why? Because now he's got to return everything that he took. And devil, we know who you are. We know your markings. For the word of God says that you are the accuser of the brethren. You're always coming to accuse someone. You're always coming to point out someone's mistakes and someone's difficulties. But today, I thank you that we are strengthened. I thank you that we are encouraged. In the name of Jesus, we decree and declare that it is so, and so it is, in Jesus' name. Come on, somebody type that in. It is so.